There is a clear and present danger to those of us that own a car. The war on cars. There's no denying this war. I'm not sure why we keep hearing these Fruit Loops say that there's no such thing as a war on cars. Almost 40,000 Americans were killed in car traffic last year. You know what that means? Thousands and thousands of cars were damaged last year. It's disgraceful. It's such a waste of money. Now, I know there are auto manufacturers out there who maybe are thinking, well, more crashed cars means more people buying replacement cars, and that's good for business. But we, the auto owner, know differently. We value that prized possession. I'm working my butt off for these monthly payments. I don't want my car crashed. I want to protect it. Well, I figured out who's waging this terrible war on cars. It's all these experts that design streets like they're drag strips. Now, of course, I'm a perfect driver and I've never exceeded the speed limit, but everybody else is doing it. And it's not because we hate our cars. Excuse me, it's not because those people hate their cars. It's because those people are driving on roads that are encouraging them to have lousy behavior. Motorists don't want to crash their cars. They value their cars. So here's what we've got to do to end this war on cars once and for all. We, the car owners, need to rally together and insist that experts, the politicians, the planners, the engineers, insist that these experts build street networks that allow us to drive slowly and peacefully so that we can preserve our amazing vehicles that cost a fortune to keep in our garages. That 45 mile an hour four-lane street through your neighborhood, that thing's part of the war on cars. So it turns out we, the car owners, should be joining this Vision Zero campaign. We gotta preserve these vehicles. Narrower lanes, more of those bike lanes, more of those crazy thick crosswalks so we have pedestrians all over the place. I want people all over the place so that my car is slowly moving and is kept safe.